Hello, I'm Nick Pryke and you're watching Meet the Boss TV. In this episode, what does it mean to take your workforce truly mobile? In today's always on consumer society, efficiency is expected as standard. But for the enterprise, getting it right in the mobile arena is an ongoing battle, and its workforce are at the very front line. I spoke with Mike Karlskind, VP of Service Optimization Strategies at ClickSoftware, to find out how mobile workforce management is proving to be a pivotal piece of the puzzle.
We define the mobile workforce as mostly everyone and everything. The mobile workforce more and more is becoming, rather than the traditional mobile workforce of a field service technician or an engineer out in the field, we find that it's spread beyond that to now include the supervisor and then to start to include executives and managers and everyone who wants to have visibility. And then finally, those traditional back office workers that used to, in the old days, you know, purely be the desktop users and there was a clear delineation between them. Now that delineation is starting to fall down because people are starting to take their work home with them. And likewise, people are even starting to bring their personal lives to work. And as that line between the two really starts to blur, even the back office workers need to start to have more of that mobility, whether it be on a tablet or whether it be on their smartphone for off hours. We see and we know and we are preparing ourselves to address the fact that as time passes, virtually everyone will be mobile.
So you touched upon this idea of delineation and blurred lines, which is clearly the case. So from the ClickSoft perspective then, where do you see the greatest challenges emerging from for the enterprise when we're talking about leveraging the power of a truly mobile workforce?
I think it's first in changing the perception about what mobility is about. Mobility, as it's traditionally been defined, has really been more about how do I get the job out there? How do I actually, reduce paper and do something I used to do on paper at the end of the day or at the end of the week? How do I now do that via a mobile device? You know, we all hear about this faster world that we're living in and this expectation that people now have. You know, everyone who has a smartphone can do their banking remotely, can, check their account, their Starbucks account remotely, and pay with things, and I can scan barcodes and price and shop and do everything just on this smartphone. So when someone shows up to my house, even if I'm not an expert in mobility, I'm surprised that they actually have to call back into the office very often to get information or to take some action that I would expect them to be able to take right from their smartphone just based upon, my simple view of things. It extends out even now to, changing the perspective of the executive. So whereas the executive used to be able to, at best, get some sort of simple report, now they want to be able to get really all of the information they need in one place on their mobile device, but then even turn around and take action. I think the other challenge is really in terms of the data. It's one thing to talk in theory about being able to do these things that we did in the past, now remotely out in the field, but it's another thing to actually connect to all those back office systems that provide that information. So if you take, for example, let's say one of the things that we hear very often is companies want to do training out on the mobile. So if I have a field workforce that used to come into the office to be able to get some morning training, to get some procedures, announcements, now I need to be able to, save that time, of course. So I want to tell my people, hey, don't come into the office to actually get that information. I want to be able to provide those training, those announcements, all via the mobile device. So it's really the content, the data that you need to get out there, finding a way to get it out there and get it out there in obviously a consumable format.
And so it is with a combination of data dissemination and control that enterprises are starting to latch onto the potential of proactive mobile workforce management. But has anybody got it right yet?
If you can imagine the regulated utility industry, You have a lot of challenges with the need to not only provide information out to the field, but to be able to pull information from multiple systems. So you have a GIS system that has all of your network assets on it. You have the customer information system, which actually has, obviously, all the customer information. And then you have the order management system. And all of this data needs to be pulled together to be able to give the work out to the resources. And then as they pull it back together, it needs to come in one stream to be able to go back and become part of a regulatory report. But added to that, we actually have to track what actually comes, what they actually did. Several years ago in Northern California, there was a massive gas explosion. And the fine that went along with that was easily into the tens of millions of dollars. And a lot of the challenge that came from that was really that they had no way to track that they had actually done the inspections on the assets in the area to prevent that type of event. So now, as this other client of ours, Sempra Energy, in Southern California, as they've actually looked to bring all that information first out to the field, they're actually compiling it along with the activities that occur in the field, and it all becomes part of that one singular report that goes back into the back office, gets distributed back to the individual systems, but then is available as a singular record to indicate to the regulator that they've actually been diligent in their job.
And with a recent report indicating that as of Q1 this year, the average number of mobile devices owned by in-field employees sits at 3 per person, that singular record is proving invaluable. With ClickSoftware's philosophy of time is not just money, time is freedom, I asked Mike if a paradox was prevailing between the freedom of a mobile workforce and the constrictive nature of a fragmented mobile ecosystem.
First, we might ask ourselves, freedom from what? Because in this case, you know, freedom from your desk, yes. Freedom from having to be in the office, yes. Freedom from actually getting your work done, no. I think we're all challenged by just the way the economy and the way workplace expectations are. I think the key is continuity between them all. So that when you actually are working, for example, you know, if I'm working on, you know, and driving around in my vehicle, that I might have a vehicle-mounted laptop that has lots of information, and I'm able to get the job, be navigated to the job, be suggested, of different routes to take. It might call the customer for me. So that's all great. But then when I get out of that vehicle, I may not want to carry that whole device with me. So now I'm carrying a smartphone in to just complete the details of the job and the status and find out where in the building the asset might be, something of that nature. And I think the freedom really lies in being able to actually be wherever you are, whether it's in the office with your desktop or your laptop, in the vehicle with a mounted device, with your smartphone or with your tablet, and having continuity of the information along each one of those, and to be able to do something as simply as to use the same login across all of your devices and be presented with the same information in a similar format. This is really where the freedom from the office and the freedom from your vehicle really comes from, that now I can be anywhere, anytime, whether it's my bedroom, or whether it's the shopping mall, or whether it's on-site at the customer's business or home. In all of these cases, this is really where the freedom lies, but that challenge is, how do I provide that continuity across all those platforms?
Undeniably, continuity along with usability are key ingredients to any mobile workforce management initiative. But what else needs to enter into the recipe? Here's Mike's take on what enterprises need to consider prior to implementation.
I think if we've all learned one lesson, whether it's as observers ourselves or analysts, whatever the case may be, we've all learned that the mobile world is one where we can't predict where it's going to be tomorrow or the next day. So as I'm looking to be able to have a good, solid, you know, mobile strategy, I need to have a strategy that leaves room for me to take advantage of whatever the next technologies are. And so when we look at a strategy moving forward, we need to be open and have a platform that allows us to actually take advantage of that into the future. Many of us have started to hear the terms like big data and predictive analytics and these types of things. And it's one thing to be able to actually collect this data. It's another thing to be able to actually gain intelligent insights out of it. But an even bigger challenge is how do we actually present it in a consumable way that contributes to the goals of what we're trying to do, whether that be towards customer service, being able to actually present that information to the customer-facing representative so that they can actually leverage it while they're there. How can we make our employees safer? How can we make them more productive? These are all challenges that I think are not well addressed at this moment. Generally speaking,
one way to unveil better insights into productivity comes with better analytics. Clearly, there is no one size fits all, but from real time to predictive, how can the right analytics impact how productive a mobile workforce can truly become?
Well, I think first, predictive analytics is something that I think everyone understands conceptually what it is, but I would say it's not yet reached the practical applications in many cases. But I think as we continue to learn and evolve our understanding of how predictive analytics can be applied, we can start to use it more towards the actual workforce itself. So looking inward at who do I work with in terms of collaboration? Who do I typically talk to? Who are the what we call the go-to people in the organization that actually have the best knowledge? What are the products or the job types where there typically is greater failure? And we can actually turn around and use that information to actually make us more predictable in terms of, how will we behave? And as a result, to get ahead.
And while mobile devices are inherent to any mobile workforce, they only function within the context of enhancing better experiences for all concerned. So how can companies leverage mobility to make better customer service decisions and unveil new insights?
This is really, when we talk about the utopia of customer service and creating remarkable customer service experiences, this usually comes from, number one, meeting the expectations of the customer in terms of when can you actually get there. And then number two is, once you're there, having all the information available that you need. So if you need to be able to diagnose a problem, being able to do that. And even having videos for training or videos for how to address a specific problem. To me, it's always, and I think to many, it's always perplexing why they send a technician out and he does his work, and then all of a sudden we wait for another 45 minutes while he's calling into the back office, into some sort of network operations center, to actually have them perform all sorts of tasks, waiting for them to call back, then testing it, and all of that dialogue, knowing that, he's got a mobile device. All that is just basically something electronic that's happening. And why can't he actually take care of that right then? So being able to really perform the job efficiently in front of the customer, because customers do pay attention, and being able to free up the customer's time because we're able to get the job done the first time, get it done efficiently, these are all the things that now customers expect. And this is really what drives, a happy customer.
And from customer expectations to those of the business, I wrapped up by asking Mike to point out the hidden challenges enterprises should be looking out for when it comes to achieving exceptional customer experience.
Yeah, I think when we look at hidden challenges, we can, again, of course, as I said before, when we talk about the mobile side and mobile workforce management in general, I would repeat the challenges, of course, of the big change and the data, the necessity for data. But I think one of the others is to really establish what is your balance as a company that you actually want to see employed. I alluded to earlier the fact that now we're taking some of those decisions that we actually used to make, manually with humans. And these, on the one hand, humans can make good decisions on a one-off basis. On the other hand, very often those decisions were disconnected from where the company wants to be, from the strategic or the executive level. And now with mobile workforce management and the technology that's available to actually optimize and automatically schedule the workforce, we get a tremendous benefit. We can make decisions more quickly, we can make them automatically and according to a very specific criteria. Everywhere from skills to how do we want to balance cost savings versus customer service. If you can imagine, you know, I can maximize customer service just by putting 10,000 technicians out in the field, but that doesn't do much for my cost of service. And likewise, I can really save on cost of service if I only have one technician out there, but every customer has to wait. So somewhere in between that, there is a balance. And where companies want to end up on that balance is actually pretty well known at the strategic level. But typically, there's been a disconnect, and there's been no definition of that at the operational level, the people who actually face the customers. So to actually define within your company to say, here is the balance level that we would like to achieve, and to put that into the software and ensure that the decisions that are made every day, day in, day out, according to that balance, is something that companies don't typically think of.
For more fantastic interviews directly related to your business, be sure to explore Meet the Boss TV.